actually in a riverbed at the moment. When the rains do come, this is going to be impossible to drive along here like this. But it's also a great place for animals to find shade, slightly cooler. Obviously, with this being a river line, there's going to be a little bit more moisture below the surface. Elephants will actually dig holes to find fresh water. They actually like to drink fresh water. So there. Branches breaking, which is, I should be hearing around here. A little bit further south than Chalapan. So the only tracks I had were actually leading down into the drainage line now. There's nothing in the drainage line, so I may have moved. To the vegetated areas. Oh, there we go, there's some more tracks here going that way. It might be in this side rather than that side then. Live, so 100% live from the African bush. So if you've never been on a safari before, this is pretty much what you'll do if ever you do come out to Africa to go on a safari. You drive around in the bush for anywhere between 2-4 hours, usually in the morning, later on in the afternoon, when the animals are a bit more active, especially in the summertime. There's a cootie running across the road. And you look for anything else of interest, whether it be trees or birds. And if there's a lot of animals around, we take advantage of that. But if there's not so much around, then start looking at the smaller things. Some rhino tracks crossing over that direction. Okay, I've got one more spot to try. This side, and that's why we weren't hearing any branches breaking on that side. of old dead trees lying around. He had them, and they're in this very, very thick part of the bush in front of us. Or they've crossed over already. Branches breaking here either. I hear a black-headed oriole calling. Again, a very liquid call. Actually crossed over. There's nothing crossing over onto the western side, so they may have crossed over onto the eastern side and actually gone through the drainage line up onto the back there. Looks like they have been drinking, look. I'm using that to drink from. And they actually use the sand to filter the water, and it's a lot more clearer. I'm still not hearing the sounds of branches breaking. We'll carry on until we can. Thank you. and we had the big tree in the way. Okay.
I think the elephants have actually already crossed over because I'm not hearing anything in there. Say these tracks and the other tracks coming in. They have made their way over already.
There's a tree in the way.
So we're gonna have to get back the way we came.
But also, it's definitely worth watching the waterhole camera. Gowrie Dam, just have to drive. So the elephants are in the area. They may or may not have been able to get enough water from there. Doesn't look like there was much that came out there actually, so they may still make their way down to Gowrie Dam to drink. Get a chance to see the vervet monkeys away from the lodge. Again, they know where to utilize to find food. They're hiding from us now. I can just see a branch. Let's see if we can roll forward a little bit. Can you see them through there now? As we start to close down from this morning's drive. Hopefully we'll be able to try and catch up with the elephants later on this evening. And as I say, it was wonderful to actually see some interaction from those dogs. And you never know, we might be lucky enough to see them, but if not, at least we were able to spend some time with such a wonderful species. It's awesome. Thank you so much for joining us, everybody. I hope you've enjoyed the drive this morning. I'm Tara, I've been your guide. Alex has been on camera. Mark has been in final control. For myself and the rest of the crew, take care, and we'll see you again at 3 o'clock. Bye for now.